Toilet to tap is a crude, gross, but the most direct description of how Westminster plans to resolve its Achilles heel. A scarce water supply.
I think it sounds disgusting. I wouldn't want to drink it.
That's just a little bizarre, I think, to try to turn sewer water into drinking water.
The initial ick factor of turning sewage into drinking water is enough to make you gag. But we've learned the process it goes through to create the end product will be easy to swallow.
We can't just say that, we have to prove it.
It's a four-stage process.
The first drop of wastewater that is generated all the way to the water that is distributed to the users.
Engineers Ben and Zore Movahead are a Gaithersburg-based husband and wife team who designed the system called Pure Water Westminster. To sell the idea to state regulatory agencies and local officials, they built a mini water filtration plant for a 9-month pilot program. They took thousands of samples, they say, that often surpass federal standards.
I drank it, the director of public works drank it, the mayor drank it.
The process is called indirect potable use. It begins with diverting filtered treated wastewater that would usually be released into the environment, into the new water purification plant. The water is filtered again through membranes that remove microscopic particles.
First is ultrafiltration to remove pathogens, viruses, and bacteria.
But the reverse osmosis is the heart of this process.
The membranes are in layers. The feed water is forced by pressure to go through here, and each one of these is connected to the center tube. The water that passes through the membrane ends up as clean water in this center tube.
There are 6 reverse osmosis membranes in each of these long white tubes. The process even removes the forever chemical PFAS. The water then travels through 6 miles of pipe to the Cranberry Reservoir. Now, this is the primary source of drinking water for Westminster. Watech says there are built-in safeguards in case of mechanical issues or power outages. The results led to a change in state law that allows turning sewage into drinking water.
We are 100% confident that there would not be any issues.
Westminster has a long history of water supply struggles, in part because its location is not near a large river or lake. It relies on wells and the Cranberry Reservoir, both dependent on rainwater.
I'm definitely a little bit grossed out about it, but if there's any way to find more sources in, you know, water and all of that, I think it would be good.
Construction on the $14 to $16 million facility will begin in January. The plant will treat 10% of the city's wastewater and be available to residents in about 2 years. They guarantee it will be safe and pure, but it's also necessary. In Westminster, for 11 News Investigates, I'm David Collins.